In the real world, preparing people for the real world. It's now widely accepted that Britain's future will be as a skills and knowledge-based economy, and we have in front of us a massive opportunity, but one that can be grasped only by a step change in the nation's skills. And that in turn requires a step change in how we deliver education and training. For the majority of our students, over half of whom are part-time, the university would easily compete with universities in the top 60. I would now like to turn briefly to our reach beyond Bolton. We have great strength in our international ties. Long before Bolton became a university, links were forged around the world. As you heard from the Vice-Chancellor, degrees have been awarded throughout the world. We have our own flourishing campus in Ras Al Khaimah, and the foreign students, almost 850 of them, studying here in Bolton, add to the rich diversity of university life. I would like to thank the Governing Council for placing their trust in me, because becoming Chancellor of the University marries two of my great loves, education and Bolton. But it also has another link. For the house in which my mother grew up in, the house where she cultivated her love of literature, was knocked down. And in time, over the ground where the house once stood, was built the University of Bolton. And so for me, this university is a very special place, and I am deeply honoured and enormously proud to become its first Chancellor.